Welcome back to my channel. I am the garden and worm lady. By the way, do you like my shirt? I know it's backwards, but if I turn this around, then I can't see what I'm actually filming. It says, just a girl who loves worms. So today we're going to check on the breeders and we're going to see if they need to be fed. We're going to feed them. I dyed my hair midnight black and it turned out blue. Like, look, we're still rocking the blue. I don't know why. Usually I color my hair with henna, a natural plant, but you know, I'm tired and this knee thing is just bugging me and I just felt like using box hair dyes. I'm like, ah, what the heck? And yeah, I made it blue. So I think I'm going to rock the blue for a while. So, anyway, let's get started. Tractor Supply for me is just really close by. It's in another town, but it's a, you know, close by farm store that I can, that I can get them in. These worms are gorgeous, guys. Like, they really are. Wow. So I'll be harvesting some of this today to ship out. Let me show you how I ship. So I gather European nightcrawlers, they're bedding and everything, and I put it in one of these containers and I wait for the light to send them down. Then I start removing the bedding from the top. Once I have a mound of worms, I weigh them first. I make sure that my scale's on zero and I weigh them. Once I reach a pound, I add a little more worms to it so I could go over a pound because worms dehydrate a little bit on their journey. So I want to make sure the person gets what they paid for. Wow, look at that one. So after I do that, I put them in here. This bedding will be gone, you know, it'll be back over there. And I mix them with peat moss. I ship them in these bags. They're called no scratch bags. I get them at yulin.com. They're really soft. They hold a pound of worms and more very well. And I zip tie it. When I zip tie these bags, I've never had someone tell me that the worms escaped. So I like using them. They come in, I think, two different sizes now. I usually try to get the larger size because it just makes more sense in case I'm going to ship more than a pound. So someone is getting these guys and they're very lucky. So that's how this process works. So you see, as the worms go down, I just start grabbing bedding and I put it in here because this is going to go back over there. European nightcrawlers to me are easier to ship. Because they're easier to grab because they're bigger, you know, they just are. So when you buy, like, if I sell 50 worms, I go through here and I pick out the fattest ones. Like, I count them 1, 2, 3, 4, you know, and then I ship them. So yeah, these are definitely easier to ship than the red wigglers, but I do both anyway. I love them all. They're all my babies. Okay, look what I found. You see that little egg? That's a cocoon. And you see how it's like a light color? That was just recently laid. So in about 21 days, maybe a little more, this cocoon will hatch and there'll be little babies in there. So I am finding tons of cocoons. Look at this one. Oh, wow, that's a good shot for this camera. Let me see if I could flip it over a little bit. Oh, how sweet. It's life, guys. It's life in there. Wow. Oh, look, you can see him in the middle. I never seen one inside the cocoon like that. Look. Oh, he's moving. Oh my gosh, how sweet. What a moment. Wow. I'm just, wow. My gosh. Oh, guys, I'm so glad I got that on camera. Wow. You guys are going to really enjoy that as much as I did. That is amazing. blows me away. Look at this worm. It's huge. My gosh. So we just keep going till we get close to the bottom, you know? That is a very large worm. Wow. Giant European nightcrawler. Look at that. Impressive. We're getting close to the bottom, so you want to see the big flop? This is so much fun to do. Oh my gosh, look at that. They're massive. They're like little snakes. These are nice big European nightcrawlers. Wow. We're getting close. So once I hit the pound, I go over a little. Then I dump this and I remove the rest of that bedding. So this is how I do it. I pick out the whoppers, you know. Look at the size of this thing. Wow. Those are the ones that'll give you the weight in your scale, you know, because they're huge. Look at that. I am seeing a lot of cocoons, guys. Look. Like a lot. They are breeding like crazy. They really are. They are loving this. Look at this. Look at the size of that worm. Wow. Impressive. Look at this one. Every time I think I found the biggest one, I find another one. So look at that. It's more than a pound. Look at them all. They're a little ticked off at me. So the rest of this bedding with the rest of the worms in here, and you know, it's loaded with cocoons. I'm just going to keep adding a few more. I'm going to throw it back in the bin and feed them and cover them and let them settle down, because they're a little angry at me right now because I've been messing with them. Sorry, guys. This is something else I want to show you. So I put them in here so they can go down and I can get the rest of the bedding off. You see those bubbles? See the bubbles? That means that they're very upset. When worms get upset, they release this slimy stuff. It's and it creates these bubbles, and they're kind of stressed. So I'm gonna mix them with peat moss and I'm gonna pack them up and get them out the door immediately. And I always ship my worms priority. So I do my best to get these worms 100% clean. But let me tell you something. There is no way you will ever get these 100% clean unless you put them in a sifter and run them underwater. And I'm not about to do that to them. So as they go down, I take off as much as I can. The little bit I leave there doesn't make a difference in more or less worms, because I measured them out before anything. And let me tell you a little tip I heard years ago from another worm farmer who I met in Texas when I first started. He always told me, always ship your worms with a little bit of their own bedding, just a little bit. He says that it creates an environment that is not 100% sterile for them. So when I put them in peat moss is a sterile material that they haven't been in yet, but their own bedding they have, and it has all the microbes and everything in it. And he says that by him doing that, he had I think it was 98% success rate in shipping and, you know, live arrival. So, and when you think about it, at least to me, it makes sense. So am I always going to get them 100% clean? No, nobody does. Don't let them fool you and tell you yes, because they don't. They just don't. They're looking good though. So as they go down, I just keep taking some off. And yeah, the bubbles, yeah, they're they're a little aggravated with me. But that's all right. You're going to a good home. So, let's see. All right. Another mistake you can make when you're shipping worms is not adding enough peat moss. Peat moss acts as an insulator for them. It insulates them and protects them from the weather, the extremes, whether it be cold or hot. So cheaping out on the peat moss is not a good idea, because then if they arrive dead, then you're at a loss. You can either replace them, which is more worms that, you know, you got to replace, and or refund people. It's just not good. Just add the peat moss. I always add more than what I normally see people add. And that's only because that's always, I've had success like that. And my goal is to get these worms to their destination alive. Once they get there, it's up to you to keep them alive. But my goal is live delivery. And I think that's most worm farmer standards. So, oh my gosh, they feel so good. Wow, I love playing with them. I know they're mad at me, but I still like playing with them. Yay! All right. So I'm going to take this bedding and put it over here. Oh, peat moss. You know how I love the smell of peat moss. Not really. So you just give them a good mix. Make sure they're coated. Get some supplies on yulin.com. They are expensive, but you know, it's the only place I could really get those bags that I love in huge quantities. So see, they're really coated. So now I grab my bag and I just start stuffing. Bobby from Missouri Worm Supply came up with a contraption. I think it's like a PVC pipe where you can funnel them into your bag. I'm definitely gonna have to copy your idea, Bobby. Sorry. It just makes it easier than just going like this one by one. But this is how I do it. So thank you for that genius idea. Here's the bag. Okay, this is another thing I do. When I tie my worms, I don't tie it like this 100% tight. I give them a little wiggle room and I spin it like 3 or 4 times. Then I zip tie it. Guys, I've never had a worm escape.
There it is. A little more than a pound of euros. And it's on its way out. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope you learned something. So they're going to go in here. See, my label's nice and straight. I'll put them in there. I'll pack them really well with paper. And off they go. Press that subscribe button. Don't forget to follow my other channel, The Worm Lady 2. And I'll see you all next time. Take care.
So in the box, I include my business card. And I include this instruction little pamphlet. I packed it with paper at the bottom, the worms, more paper, and then I go to pirate ship there and I ship and off they go. So let's see, this 1 pound of euros with everything in it is 36.0 ounces. So I always add a little more. So let's see, 36.1. Let's see. So now I'm going to get the rate. Let me see. I'm just trying to cover addresses. All right, let me see if it shows me. Okay, so shipping these worms priority is going to cost me $6.82. So, and they'll get there, it says here, by Thursday. So I don't know what that would cost if I go to the post office, but that's a pretty good rate.
Well, hi guys. Welcome back to my channel. I am the Garden and Worm Lady. I have the giggles today. I don't know. Some days I just laugh more than others. But anyway, I'm going to get through this. Okay.